Hello guys, welcome back to my channel San and Nastaki. And in today's video we will discuss something very basic on SAN storage. So we will discuss the SAN architecture. So within that we will discuss what are the components of SAN storage architecture, how SAN components are connected to each other, and how SAN network works. So before proceeding further, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that whatever new video I upload in my series or in my entire channel, you'll get a notification immediately. Now, the component of SAN storage can be divided into three layers. So first layer is the host layer, fabric layer, and then the storage layer. So host layer has servers or the host having its own resources with a dual HBA card. So we will discuss about these layers in details in coming slides, but for now these are the some basic definition of the components. So fabric layer are collection of SAN switches. So the switches may be brocade or it can be Cisco switches. And storage layer has the storage array where actually the data reside. Now let's first discuss about host layer components. Host layer consists of one or many hosts or servers. So these are nothing but the hardwares, and inside that hardware operating system will run, and hosts are the components where database or applications are installed, and these database or application will access the storage from the storage array. So these host has a HBA card, which is also called as host bus adapter card. These HBA cards will have FC ports. So usually one HBA card will have two FC ports, which connects to the SAN switch port. So for higher redundancy, some host has dual HBA card with four FC port. So there will be four connections from the HBA card to the SAN switches. Next one is the fabric component. So fabric layer consists of one or more SAN switches. So if your environment has one switches, then it can be called as a standalone switch. Or if it has more than one SAN switches connected to each other, then it will be called as a fabric. So fabric is nothing but it's a collection of SAN switches. And SAN switches actually provides connection points in SAN architecture. So what will happen is that all the host will be connected to the SAN switches, and also the storage array will connect to the same SAN switches. So in this way, SAN switch will be a connection point between the host and the storage array. So SAN network has two fabric for higher redundancy, so that if one fabric goes down, then other fabric will take care. So these details will be more clear when we will see the actual diagram how the SAN components are connected to each other. The next is storage components. Storage components of SAN are the storage array where actually the data resides. All these storage array will have a dual storage processor, and these SPs or the storage processor are the front end of the storage array. So what will happen that this SP has front end IO module, and these IO module has FC ports which connects to the SAN switch. Now where exactly the data resides in the storage components? So these storage will have a physical disk in it, and in those physical disk the data will resides. But the disk array uses special technology called RAID for data protection. So as it's a hardware, so most likely there is a chance of failure of this disk. So whenever a disk fails happens, the data will be retrieved or recovered from the other disk. So this recovery is possible because of the technology called RAID, redundant array of independent disk. So there are many RAID types. So based on the situation or based on the requirement, different RAID types can be selected for configuring the disk array. Now this is a basic SAN network architecture. So let me tell you what exactly these are. So this part is the host layer. So here we can see we have only one host, and as we discussed, host layer will have HBA. So you can see there are two HBA, HBA1 and HBA2. And the second layer is the SAN layer. Here we can see there are two SAN switches. These two SAN switches are independent of each other. It means that one SAN switch can be called as fabric A and the other SAN switch can be called as fabric B. And here we can see the connection. So HBA1 is connected to fabric B and HBA2 is connected to fabric A. So this is how the redundancy is provided. So suppose this HBA is filled, then other HBA is there to support the SAN operations. And if at all entire switch is also filled, then other switch is there to take over the traffic. And this is the storage array, and the switches are connected to these storage array, and the storage array will have the SP. Here we can see two SP are there, and one of the SP is connected to fabric B and one of the SP is connected to fabric A. So in each layer of SAN network there is redundancy. In host layer there is redundancy in terms of HBA, in the switch layer or the fabric layer in terms of switch we have redundancy, and in case of storage array as well we have redundancy in terms of storage processor, that is SP. So now let's discuss how SAN storage works. So these are the theoretical part, but we will also explain with the help of the diagram. So whenever a host wants access to a storage device on the SAN, it sends a block based access request for the storage device, and those requests are nothing but the SCSI commands, and these are encapsulated into FC packet, that is fiber channel packets. So SAN network entirely works on fiber channel protocol. Host HBA transmits the FC request or the package to the SAN switches. Now depending on the connectivity between HBA to fabric switch port, one of the SAN switch will receive the request, and that request will again send it to the storage array for processing, and the storage array will process that request and send it back to the host through the same path through which the request has came to the storage array. Now let's discuss these points with the help of this diagram. So as we can see here, the host will send a request, and the HBA will receives the request first, and then it will send it to the SAN switch. It may be received by fabric B or it may be received by fabric A, and then the SAN switch will send the request to the storage processor of SAN storage. The request is a read request, then it will read the data from its storage array, and then it will send it back through the same path through which the request has came to the storage array. Now if it is a write request, then also it will send an acknowledgement back to the host that the data has been written to the storage array through the same path through which the request has came to the storage array. Now let's see a typical SAN storage architecture. We have two servers, and each server has two HBAs, and each of that SBA is connected to both fabric. Here we can see this server is connected to fabric A and it has also been connected to fabric B. Similarly, this server is connected to fabric A and this has also been connected to fabric B. Now in case of storage layer also we can see there is redundancy. So from fabric A there are two connections made. One connection is to SP of one storage array and the other connection is to SP of another array. So similar connection is also there from fabric B. Obviously these are just the physical connectivity part. So many more things such as zoning in SAN switches, registration of host in storage component needs to be done so that a successful access can be established between the storage array and the host layer. The SAN storage architecture is little bit clear to you guys. If you have any questions or any other knowledge to share on this topic, you can put your feedback in comment section. And once again, don't forget to share this video and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will be notified for more such videos in future immediately. Thank you for watching.